Alongside him, Jaco Mos, who takes the lead. Kim Ki-hoon, who now leads from Mos. Then it's O'Reilly in third place, and at the back, Kawasaki. So it's quite a tough semi-final, this one.
O'Reilly has to try and go on Kim Ki-hoon's back. Ki-hoon's been the most impressive skater so far in these 1,000 metres, and he'll dominate this race if he's given half a chance.
Yes, Ki-hoon won this event and the 3,000 in the World Student Games this year at Sofia. Gold medalist, remember, in the 1500 at Calgary in the Olympics. So it's Ki-hoon who starts this, I would think, as favourite, because O'Reilly has shown he's not in top form, and he'll desperately want to get through to the final here to get his first points on the board. That'll help him to qualify for the 3,000 metres. So it's all riding on this for O'Reilly. His pride very much at stake, and this a vital race in his career. O'Reilly moves into second place.
Great move, though, O'Reilly. Because the other two lose concentration and down they went.
Yes, it's certain now, or is it certain that he'll get through? Because remember, he had that mess up in the quarterfinals of the 500. Let's hope it's not the same.
He's been warned about it, and I'm sure he'll stay out of trouble this time. I think he'd like to psych the Korean out a bit here, because he knows he's a major contender come the final. So he'll do his best to put one over on him.
So unless there's a fall, these two are through to the final of the 1,000 metres. And O'Reilly, for the first time in 3 days, can relax. Or can he? He still looks as if he's got another trick up his sleeve. Little glance across, a few words exchanged into the last lap. And here he comes. Yes, O'Reilly takes it on. And Kim Ki-hoon says, if you want it that way, you will go ahead. Oh, dear. In his moment of glory, O'Reilly can't get it all exactly right.
That was O'Reilly at his cheeky best there. He just wanted to get one over on the Korean and show he still functions, still in there with a chance of winning. But you see here, he's put the other two under so much pressure coming through late into the corner. They just lost concentration and down they went.
And here's Archie Marshall, the British team coach, who's been commentating with me this afternoon. Things beginning to look a little better for Wilf.
Very much so. Over a bad 2 days, but things are starting to come together. He's still not skating the way he can. He's still a bit tight and nervous, but he's doing what's necessary. It's a cliche, but when the going gets tough, the tough get going, and he's really getting going now.
And he's beginning to get the luck, which has deserted him.
He's getting the breaks, but he's working for them as well. And he's desperate to do well in front of this crowd who want him so much to win.
Is the main danger Lackey from Canada?
I think so, but in that semi-final, Mark was looking very tired. So I don't know if the pressure is starting to get to him as well. Kim Ki-hoon, I think, is the number one.
There's the lineup for the men's 1,000 metres final. Kim Ki-hoon from South Korea. Wilf O'Reilly from Great Britain. Mark Lackey from Canada. Yuichi Akasaka from Japan. There's O'Reilly, tense as well he might be. His chance now for his first points. O'Reilly on the inside. Kim Ki-hoon is who takes it up. O'Reilly second, Akasaka third, and at the back, Mark Lackey. 9 laps to go.
O'Reilly's got to stay out of trouble here and just save all his energy for one big burst, maybe at 3 to go, and the Crean's least expecting it. Crean expects him to go maybe in the last lap. Will's got to catch him earlier.
But here comes Akasaka on the inside. It's Akasaka from Japan who takes it up. But the others are alert to his move. Kim Ki-hoon in second, O'Reilly third, Mark Lackey tracking O'Reilly.
Lackey's not enjoying this. He's had a lot of hard races. He wanted the pace kept slow, so this suits Will. Akasaka's pushing on maybe a bit too fast too early, though.
Akasaka 3-4 metres in front. Kim Ki-hoon second, O'Reilly third, Lackey fourth. Down goes Akasaka, and it's between these three now.
O'Reilly should have went through there. Kim Ki-hoon slipped a bit as well. He should have taken his chance.
Kim Ki-hoon winding up now. The lap times are very quick. 10.17 that one. Kim Ki-hoon from O'Reilly. Lackey just behind.
Ki-hoon's got the edge now. He knows O'Reilly started to go.
Another quick lap. And it seems that O'Reilly's done for. Immediately 5 metres between Kim Ki-hoon and O'Reilly. Another quick lap. Yes, it is. 10.6 into the last lap now. And it's the winner here, Kim Ki-hoon from South Korea. Ki-hoon wins it. O'Reilly second. Mark Lackey third. O'Reilly, well, I think he'll be satisfied. At last, he's got his name on the board. He'll be on the rostrum in second place.
O'Reilly skated better in this race, but he's still not skating at his best. You see, he's still a bit tight. He should have taken Kim Ki-hoon there. He's up inside him, but he's still tight and can't find the energy to get through.
So there's the Ki-hoon wins the men's 1,000 metres. O'Reilly gets his first points, 3 for him. Mark Lackey takes 2 more. And there, the winner, Kim Ki-hoon, the Olympic champion at 1500, wins his first world gold medal here in Birmingham. O'Reilly, the 24-year-old from Sutton Coldfield, takes the silver medal. And Mark Lackey from Canada takes the bronze. And overall, with one event to go, it couldn't be closer. Mark Lackey has 9. Michel Danyot, also from Canada, has 8. Alongside him, Kim Ki-hoon. No doubts that you're physically shattered. How do you feel mentally?
Mentally, I'm very drained. 3 days of competing at this level does certain things to you that, unless you actually go through it, you could never experience.
What have you learnt from these 3 days?
Well, I've learnt that I'm still one of the best skaters in the world. And I think I've also learnt that, I don't know how, but ultimately I need to get more ice time. You know, that has to be... I can only train off the ice, which gets me so fit to a level. And as we saw throughout the competition, the more races I had, the better I got. Simply because I'm not used to skating on this type of ice, this speed of ice, at this sort of level. So really, it's down to me now for next year. I mean, looking a bit further, I think more importantly, is we've got next year's World Championships and ultimately 1992. And between now and then, you never can tell what's going to happen. I'm pleased with my performance after sort of a disastrous first 2 days, in as much as I couldn't have been any lower from a morale point of view, and I still pulled it out in the 1,000. I would say that possibly this competition here has perhaps showed not only the spectators but the press, the media, that Wilf O'Reilly isn't invincible. He doesn't just happen to put his skates on and win gold medals. He has to train hard. And, you know, I'm not too disappointed with the overall, because I always knew it was going to be a tough challenge, because it is over 4 distances and not about 1 distance, as was in Calgary.
Yes, there's still the 3,000 metres to go, and Wilf will be in that one. But now. 1,000 metres final. Two Chinese girls here, Zhang Yanmei, is joined by Kuo Hongru. And the opposition? Sylvie Daigle, winner of the 1,500 metres from Canada. And her compatriot, Maryse Perrot. So, 12 on the inside, Kuo Hongru. Then the two Canadians, and on the outside, Zhang Yanmei. And it's Kuo who goes into the lead.
I think the Chinese will try and control this race. They don't want the kind of pace that Daigle could skate here. They'll try and keep it slow in their laps and build it up.
So Kuo Hongru in the lead. Sylvie Daigle in third place, Zhang Yanmei second. And Maryse Perrot moving up on the inside. Maryse Perrot with seven to go in second place.
Good move by Perrot. But Daigle's quick to cover her. She's through in behind her now.
Kuo Hongru leads. Maryse Perrot second. In third place, Sylvie Daigle. First and second so far in her two races. And she moves up again.
And Daigle's starting to feel tired because at this pace, I would have expected to try and dominate this race a bit more. And as you see, she's back and forth now.
And just as you said, that moves up again on the outside. And Zhang Yanmei now trading. Four to go. And it's Kuo who leads from the two Canadians.
It's a good pace for Kuo. Just keep the Canadians under pressure now. And I'm surprised Daigle's finding it so hard at the back.
It's a vital race for Maryse Perrot, the world champion in 1982. She has to finish in front of Daigle. They're close friends. But I'm sure she'd like to stay in contention here. And she has to finish in front of her. So Kuo leads, Perrot second, Daigle third, and Zhang now a back number. Perrot into the lead.
Great pressure for Perrot there. She kept pressure on the Chinese girl till she had to break.
So Perrot first. Can Daigle get through? Yes, she can. Perrot leads, Daigle second, into the final straight, and it's Perrot who wins. Daigle second. And look at the delight on Perrot's face. She knows she's won a gold medal and still in contention for the overall title as well.
Great skating from Perrot. You can see here she's already putting the Chinese girl under pressure. The Chinese girl knows she's there and she just keeps working on her. Round outside, cuts her up just a little bit to cut the stride off the Chinese girl, and away she goes. With Sylvia Daigle pressing now to get through into second, takes the inside line and chases her down.
And the delight showing on Perrot's face. There, the result, Perrot takes 5 points, Daigle takes three, Hongru takes two, and Zhang Yanmei takes one. But the Canadians are really dominating. Perrot's 5 points move her up to nine, just two behind Daigle. One of those two girls now must win the world title.
Congratulations, you must be very pleased.
Not yet. The 2000 is left and it's not over.
Have you always, you two being obviously strong rivals, have you seen each other as the main competitors in this championship?
We didn't know. We're training together all the time, but we didn't know that we were going to be like the one we're going to fight.
Going to be for the world. One of the other, oh, sorry. One of us, it doesn't matter. Right. As long as the Canadian.
As long as one and two. Okay.
The opposition you keep beating time and time again. What keeps you going, you two?
The coach. We're having fun.
Yeah, we're having fun out there. And yeah, we like to train and we like having fun. So
now down to the 3,000. Will you be watching each other closely?
Sure.
I guess so.
Fun, yes, yeah.
Thank you.
Gonna watch her.
So eight skaters through to the ladies 3,000 meters final from Canada, Natalie Lambert. From Japan, Moriko Kinoshita. Christina Schaller from Italy, the 500-meter champion. Joël van Kotsveld, the 15-year-old from the Netherlands. The leader overall at the moment, Sylvie Daigle from Canada. Kuo Hongru from China. In second place overall at the moment, Maryse Perrot from Canada. Zhang Yanmei from China. halfway stage in the ladies' 3,000 metres. And in the lead, it's Maryse Perrault from Canada. But the lead changing hands all the time. Zhang Yanmei from China leads now. But no real pattern yet, Archie.
No, I know the Dutch are really looking forward to Coats building this because they feel she's got a real chance of winning it. They say she's been skating some great 3,000 times in training and they feel the rest of them are just a bit tired.
And she's in second place at the moment, the 15-year-old Van Cutswold from Holland. There she is, tracking Zhang Yanmei from China. In third place, Christina Schöller from Italy, winner of the 500 metres, but I would imagine her stamina a little bit suspect here.
Very much so. She's just in it making up the numbers, I'm afraid. The real race here, though, is between Daigle and Perrault, because that's who the title's between. And I'm afraid they've only got eyes for each other in this race. They don't see anything else that's going on.
Daigle right at the back. Remember, she can finish first or second here, but as long as she finishes in front of Perrault, she wins the overall title. And she knows that, so does Perrault, and Perrault anxious to get as much daylight between her and her great friend and rival as she can. But into the lead now goes Kinoshita from Japan.
Really stretching them out this time. It's a good move by Kinoshita, but she's been skating poorly track-wise this championship, and she's drifting wide already.
Van Cotswold second, Kuo Hongru from China third. Then the other Chinese girl in there as well, Chang Yanmei. And at the moment, the Canadians content to bide their time at the back.
Coats felt very relaxed, looking very confident in front here. The girl's so young, she's showing extreme maturity.
But at last, a move from one of the Canadians, and it's Maryse Perrault who's moved into third place. Maryse Perrault, number nine there, tracking Kuo and Van Cotsveld. And what is the reply from Sylvie Daigle? It's immediate. She moves in behind her.
Daigle's covering every move she makes. Good experience here from Daigle. She knows what to do and just staying on her heels.
And that is the end of the world title bid for Maryse Perrault. Just catches the feet there and out she goes. She takes Van Cotsveld out as well. And I think it's her own fault.
Very much so. It was a crazy move from Perrault. Don't know what she was thinking.
Lambert is left in front with two to go. And Daigle back in fourth place, but she's won the title wherever she goes. Kuo Hongru leads. Kuo Hongru, number 12, leads. Sylvie Daigle, fourth. And it's Sylvie Daigle who'll take the overall title. The congratulations there going to Kuo Hongru.
Definitely a brainstorm here from Perrault. I mean, when she overtakes here, she's not even passing. She leans in Coatsveld and takes them both down. Threw away a golden opportunity to win the race.
So Kuo takes the 5 points, Natalie Lambert three, Mariko Kinoshita two, but Sylvie Daigle's 1 point extends her lead at the top, and she wins the overall title. There's confirmation. She has 12 points, the silver medal to Maryse Perrault, the bronze to Kuo Hongru. Congratulations. What are your feelings? You looked as if you weren't too happy when you came off.
No, not really. In the race, when I saw that my partner, my Maryse fell, and I felt kind of disappointed for her because we could have finished first. Both of us could have finished first. So I was kind of disappointed for her.
Did that take the edge off the rest of the race for you?
Yeah, I think so. Because when I saw her fall, I just kind of stopped, and three girls passed me, so I didn't have the guts to get them, and just...
Now you've had just a couple of minutes to reflect on it. You must be very satisfied there.
Yeah, I think I am. I didn't expect that at all. Like, I went to school this year more than I trained, so I think I'm very happy with the results. I didn't expect that at all.
Your fourth title, does it mean as much to you as it did 10 years ago?
I think it means a little... I think every title means a lot. The first one was unexpected, and I think this one feel unexpected too, so I don't know.
You obviously still got the edge, the competitive edge. You'll carry on for several years still to come?
I don't know. I really don't know. Maybe. I can't answer.
Well, thank you. You gave us a lot of pleasure and well done.
Thank you.
The men's 3,000 meters final. The lineup: Jeroen Otter from Holland, Kim Ki-hoon from South Korea, Wilf O'Reilly from Great Britain, Jaco Mos from Holland, Mark Lackey from Canada in joint second place at the moment. Yuichi Akasaka from Japan. And the leader going into the 3000, Michel Daniaud from Canada. Just over halfway in the 3000 meters. And it's Kim Ki-hoon who leads. Yuichi Akasaka in second place. Then Otter from Holland. Wilf O'Reilly at the back at the moment. But it's Daniaud who you have to worry about. Daniaud lying two from the back there, number 12 on his helmet from Canada, who, if he wins this, wins the overall title. There's O'Reilly, who's struggling a little at the moment, must be tired.
Yeah, he's very tight. The tension of the weekend and the disappointments have taken their toll, and this is not his favourite distance, and I don't expect him to do too much on it.
So it's Kim Ki-hoon who leads from Akasaka, Otter third, and it looks like Mark Lackey from Canada moving into third place there.
Mark's doing well. I didn't expect him to hang on the front as long as this, because he's feeling the effects of the weekend as well. This is his first world championship.
Daniaud in fifth place. He'll be well aware that his main rivals, Kim Ki-hoon and Lackey, in front of him. Kim Ki-hoon, who goes into this race as the favourite.
Very much so, but Daniaud's starting to put pressure on the front men already, which you'll be surprised there. Where all the coaches thought he would leave it to the last couple of laps. But we see here he's pressurising them very early.
Akasaka makes his bid as he normally does, but Daniaud effortlessly moves up on the outside. Akasaka leads, Kim Ki-hoon tracking, but out on the outside. Into the lead goes Daniaud. So it's Michel Daniaud aiming for the world title here. Joint world champion in 1987, but looks now as if he's going to win the world title in 89 on his own. 4 metres in front, Akasaka second, Otter third, and Kim Ki-hoon is struggling.
Very much. Daniaud's only one. It looks as if he's got any energy left. He's stretching them out and they're all over the track. He's destroying them here. Tremendous skating. A worthy world champion.
Kim Ki-hoon, gold medalist in the 1500 metres in Calgary. But the 3 days of intense competition has tested the stamina of everyone. And it's Daniaud who's come out on top with two to go. Michel Daniaud. 15 metres in front, Akasaka second, Kim Ki-hoon third, Otter fourth.
Fabulous skater, look at this, world champion.
1989 world champion, Michel Daniaud. Kim Ki-hoon is second, Akasaka third, but the congratulations go to this very popular 22-year-old from Montreal, Michel Daniaud. And for Wilf O'Reilly, a disappointing time, but he ends up in 7th place, and Daniaud takes the plaudits.
Incredible that a man can have so much energy, so much strength left after 15 individual races. Look at this. Just destroys them round the outside and still finds the power to just go away from them. He could have just relaxed and sat in front.
Daniaud takes 5. Kim Ki-hoon takes 3. Akasaka takes 2. But those 5 from Daniaud extend his lead and mean that he's won the world title by 2 points from Kim Ki-hoon, Mark Lackey third, and Wilf O'Reilly finishes in 5th place with 3 points. So now the ceremony for the ladies. Sylvie Daigle, world champion in 79, 83 and 88, world champion again here in Solihull, 89. The silver medal to Maryse Perreault, who last won the world title in 1982, but still a formidable competitor. Canada then first and second. And in third place, Kuo Hongwu from China. And now the men's ceremony, Michel Daniaud wins the title on his own for the first time. Two bronze and a silver in 88, but gold here in Solihull. The silver medal goes to Kim Ki-hoon from South Korea. And the bronze medal to another Canadian, and haven't they done well here in these world championships? Mark Lackey takes the bronze.
Michelle, magnificent performance.
Yeah, pretty good. With six laps to go, I knew that I can't have it because the Korean lead all the 21st lap, and I knew that he was getting tired, and I was feeling really good.
You must have been upset with the 1,000 meters and not making that final, but you were able to put that behind you.
Yeah, I was a bit upset because I failed in the quarterfinal, but it's short track. I was nervous, but after the result of the 1,000, I knew that to be the world champion, I have to beat the Korean and Mark Lackey, and I was ready for it.
It was a tough race. You aimed to put the pressure on reasonably early.
Yeah, it was a tough race because the tempo was quite fast right off the start. But it's my type of race. I like a fast tempo because I'm in good shape, but I'm not able to lead all those laps. But I have a good sprint at the end, so it's a good race.
And a very satisfying feeling now, I should think.
Very satisfied, yeah, for sure.
Congratulations, brother.
Thank you very much.
too flamboyant, you know, really self-qualified.
Oh,
wasn't there.
Thank you. Thank you.